Thanks for joining us on the John Mendola Show, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers. Let's talk high school ice hockey. And joining us right now is Sam Elias. He's a coach. He's a guy who puts together an ice rink in Tunkhannock. Does a little bit of everything. Been doing it for a little bit of time. Let's welcome in Sam Elias here on the John Mendola Show. Well, Sam, you do a great job out there in Tunkhannock. Tell us about what you do with the Riverside Park Ice Rink.
Well, basically, John, we build an outdoor, naturally frozen rink in Riverside Park in Tunkhannock, which is a nice spot. It's right on the Susquehanna River, right at the base of a couple mountains. It's a beautiful, beautiful spot. And, you know, we've been doing it, I guess, for 17 years now. And as of late, I guess in the past decade or so, we've been pretty much built and maintained by some kids in our community. And the group of kids we have now have been doing it for so long. I guess they're ninth graders now, but they started building it when they were in sixth grade. They Saturday after Thanksgiving, they come down with their cordless drills and sledgehammers and pounding pins and get all the boards put up. And then usually a week or two later, we roll out our 364-pound piece of plastic liner and get all the wrinkles out and fill it up with water. We're lucky enough that the local fire company, Triton Hose, always comes and fills up for us whenever we ask them to, so we get some water in it, and then we just kind of cross our fingers and hope for some cold weather to come.
Well, sounds like a major project, that's for sure. You got kids as early as sixth grade coming and helping you. Now, you said these kids have done it for a few years now, and I'm sure they get some knowledge about this project because you've been at it for a little while, and you've learned things from year to year, but just imagine how these kids are going to be 10 and 15 years from now if they're still involved and part of their community there in Tunkhannock of learning what to do when it comes to making ice.
Yeah, definitely, for sure. But my hope is always that these boys, when they go their separate ways and graduate from high school or college or whatever they do, that, you know, whatever community they settle into, I'm hoping that they'll start an ice rink in their community so that, you know, other people outside of Tunkhannock can kind of enjoy the same spoils that we have here, because it's a great thing here. It's a great place for families to skate, great place for kids to just step on and try and play hockey for free. There's not too many places in our neck of the woods that really kids can do that, but you know, some weekday and weekend nights here, it's tough to even find a spot on the ice. You get so many kids here waiting to play. It's great.
We're talking with Sam Elias here. We're talking about the Riverside Park Ice Rink in Tunkhannock. And they've done it a long time there, and they get great community support, and the people really enjoy the ice out there. Sam, there is so many variables with the weather, and you're a guy who, you know, is an educator, and you're involved with math. So, you know, there's a whole lot of science with this stuff. So I'm sure, a math background that helps to have a little bit of science background with learning all these things. You could maybe be a part-time meteorologist trying to figure out what the weather's going to be, so then you can figure out how the ice is going to react to it.
Oh, yeah. It's tough. the weather, it's not just the temperature that sometimes is a factor for us. Things like snowpack on the ground matter. We're unfortunately at the base of a south-facing small hill that leads up to a set of railroad tracks, and that south-facing hill is like a heat sink. I mean, it just collects the winter sun all day long. If there's a snowpack on it, we get a much faster freeze, and the north side stays nice and cold and hard. But even in cold weather, if there's not a snowpack, the north side of our rink that's at the base of that south-facing hill often thaws out. You know, it becomes a bit of a nuisance. In fact, we're sitting in a warming shed right now, and I have three of our boys here. They were just walking around in the freezing cold water tonight, pulling all the leaves out of the ice rink because it melted naturally with this warm spell we had. But the wind, every leaf that falls in is a dark object on the ice that'll burn a hole in the ice when it finally freezes tonight. So they're walking around in this chilly night with their Wellington boots on and pulling all the leaves out of the rink. So it's even things like that you have to pay attention to if you want good ice.
Well, a lot of these kids that are involved with what you do out there at Riverside Park Ice Rink in Tunkhannock also involved with the Back Mountain Blackhawks high school ice hockey. Tell us about some of the guys that you have contributing on this year's team. I know you're one of the coaches.
Yeah, we got quite a few boys who play. Some came to the studio the other day, some did not. My son Joseph, of course, who's, you know, pretty much been doing this with me since he was 1.5, he's sitting by the fire, if nothing else. But, you know, he's one of our defensemen for Back Mountain. Alex Freer, who is originally from the Lake Winola area, but he's been coming up and skating with us, and he's one of our best players on the Back Mountain team. He's a defenseman as well. Then we have Alan Groh, Chris Ritz, Justin Kozlansky, and Drew Poznak, all who are wingers or forwards, depending on the game. Sometimes they'll rotate them in at center. And Alan and Chris have been helping almost as long as my son has. Those guys pretty much grew up on this rink and learned to play hockey here. And they're here right now. You know, they're picking leaves out of the rink when they probably have a million other things that teenage boys could and should be doing, and they're down here helping out instead.
Talk about that sacrifice that they make and that sense of community and what you guys have done kind of become contagious with these young men out there, and the kids get involved, and I think other people see it, and I'm sure it's well appreciated in the area out there. I know the gas industry is kind of booming a little bit north of you guys, but I'm sure a lot of people come to town and appreciate what you guys have done for the community, and it brings people close together. And maybe it's a weeknight or maybe a weekend that people are getting together and they're hitting the ice and having some good family time or friend time.
Yeah, for sure. The community here is great. I mean, businesses help us out. Neighbors will just walk by and, hand us, say, here's $20. We want to donate to the rink. Constantly having come home from work and have a set of hockey skates or some pile of sticks sitting on my front porch. People just donate. We even have an elderly couple who every year for, I guess, the last 5 years donate hot chocolate, just so that anybody who comes and uses our rink, everybody gets a free cup or two cups of hot chocolate. Just because this elderly couple, they're retired, they just kind of like the idea of the rink, and their grandson learned to skate here. In fact, he's one of our Back Mountain boys as well. It's a lot of fun, and we appreciate the help and support of our community.
We're talking with Sam Elias here on the John Mendola Show, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers, talking about the Riverside Park Ice Rink. The website is tunkicerink.com, so you can check it out online. And again, what these young men have done, and of course, some good leadership there from Sam Elias and some of the people in the community that have helped this thing go. So, hey, we're wishing good weather for you. I know it's going to get a little colder this week, so that'll always help, but we wish you good weather, and it looks, you see all the pictures online and what you guys do, a lot of happy faces out there and really making people smile, and especially the young men who enjoy the sport and love the sport itself.
Yeah, we're hoping for the weather to drop, and temperatures should go down tonight, so we're all sitting here with smiles on our face outside on the banks of the river here.
All right, well, enjoy your holiday, Sam, and thanks for taking some time out and joining us.
I appreciate it, John. You too. Thanks.
All right. Sam Elias on the John Mendola Show, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers.